and welcome to Let's Play Halo Reach. This is going to be my first, console recording, and this will be voiced over in post due to the fact that my game capture card does not have a microphone plug, and I'm not too keen on, recording while doing that because of the double feedback. As such, this will mostly be a very quiet and less than normal walkthrough. Either people will like it, either people don't. We'll see when it gets there. That said, I hope you enjoyed the game, and let's dive right in into the giant skull helmet on the floor. Ladies and gentlemen, our hero. Noble Whatchamacallum 6, aka you, aka George's little clone brother. Yes, I'm a bit of a George fan, leave me alone.
Contact with Visegrad relay was lost last night. All signals flatlined at 2600 hours. I responded with trooper fire teams, which have since been declared MIA.
And now you're sending us.
The Office of Naval Intelligence believes deployment of a Spartan team is a gross misallocation of valuable resources. I disagree.
Commander.
So that's our new number six.
Cat, you read his file?
Only the parts that weren't covered in black ink.
Anyone claim responsibility, sir?
Oni thinks it might be the local insurrection. 5 months ago, they pulled a similar job on Harmony. Hit a relay to take out our eyes and ears, then stole two freighters from dry dock. That cannot happen here. Reach is too damn important. I want that relay back online, Noble One.
Sir, consider it done.
Then I'll see you on the other side. Holland out.
Lieutenant.
Commander, sir.
I'm Carter, Noble Team's leader. That's Cat, Noble 2, Meal and George 4 and 5. You're riding with me, Noble 6.
Not gonna lie to you, Lieutenant. You're stepping into some shoes the rest of the squad would rather leave unfilled. Me, I'm just happy to have Noble back up to full strength. Just one thing. I've seen your file, even the parts the Oni sensors didn't want me to. I'm glad to have your skill set. But we're a team. That lone wolf stuff stays behind. Clear?
Got it, sir.
Welcome to Reach.
And so begins yet another adventure of the Spartans. Destined to die, all pricks, all giant muscle men and one giant muscle woman with robot arm. That said, this is the prequel to the main Halo game. Everyone probably seen that by now. Heck, probably everyone's seen Reach by now. At the time of recording, Halo 4 has been announced. Anniversary's coming up next month.
Listen up, Noble Team. We're looking at a downed relay outpost 50 clicks from Visegrad. We're going to introduce ourselves to whoever took it out, and then Kat's going to get it back online.
Get me under the hood, Commander.
Sir, why would rebels want to cut up Reach from the rest of the colonies?
You get a chance, maybe you can ask him, George.
Commander, we just lost our signal with HQ.
Backup channels.
Searching. Nada. Can't say what's jamming us.
You heard her. Dead zone confirmed. Command will not be keeping us company this trip.
I'm lonely already.
Down attempts are likely, so keep your distance.
Yes, sir.
Let's stay focused. Watch your sectors.
There's the communications outpost.
Read them a distress beacon.
And here we have the eternal pan your camera to get a good grasp of the controls and then say if you want this or inversion thing. This has been in practically every shooter ever.
Could be the missing troopers. Let's check it out.
I still wonder why devs don't think we are capable enough to just change this ourselves in the options, but hey, who's bitching? At least they're giving it to us.
June, I want your eyes on the sky. Sir.
June. MIA since day one.
Let's go, Six.
The only thing I never liked about this game is how you essentially have a mission with just about every noble member. Two, maybe three times, and then you have Jun, who only gets one. Granted, it's a fairly long one, but still, it's only one.
Distress beacon's coming from just south of you, Commander. We're close.
Structure point 34 looks clear from this angle.
Roger that. Eyes peeled.
Found the beacon.
Make out any ID?
Negative, but it's military.
So where are all the troopers?
Explosives residue.
Noble 3, can you confirm any EX residue in the area?
Negative, sir.
Plasma, maybe. Can't be. Not on reach.
There's a lot of blood on the ground. All right, Noble, looks like there's nothing here. Let's move on.
And as always, it's ominous and kind of overwhelming for all the Nobles that there could be aliens on the rock. Of course, they never stopped to think about that, did they? For that matter, I never did get why the in-universe people all expect the Covenant never to pop on their planet. I mean, they're aliens. They have spaceships. What's so weird about not expecting giant aliens to just land on your rock? Granted, they don't know where Earth is, but
I'm seeing heat six and the
yeah, I totally expect them.
On your knees, now!
They're not rebels, they're farmers. Look at them.
Ask them what they're doing here. Mit krestikit.
Magnamar katuk min honli.
Hiding, sir.
Teknav adye, asomsidot isha chodladyat. She called us.
Neighbors were attacked last night. He heard screams. Gunfire. Stopped around sunrise. Says something in the fields killed his son.
Something.
Commander, be advised. I'm reading heat signatures in that structure directly east of your position. Over.
Copy that. Get them back inside.
Osman Tombepoli. Get it?
A small nitpick I do have with this game, however, is that despite the fact that in the early stage it shows a bit of Hungarian, it never does translate it. Later on in a cutscene they do show Hungarian text, but we have no idea what it means, unless you happen to be Hungarian. That said, it's not hard to guess what they're saying, but still, it'd be nice if they actually translated that instead of just writing it down in Hungarian.
It's messy.
Well, it's clean for now. Give him 5 minutes. Not even that.
Boss, I see movement outside your structure.
Here we go.
And such the blasting fest begins.
They're headed into the basement. Move down to the lower level.
The only thing I never did appreciate about these games is how it continuously thinks you're a moron. To elevate my point, it says, press this button to toss grenades, press this button to aim, press this button to fire, press this button to do this, this button to that. It's nice that they have an in-game tutorial, but had it been really adaptive, it would check your achievements, check your playthroughs. This is my bazillion playthrough, I guess. And it should check and know that the player has already beaten it. Hell, I'm not entirely sure, but I think even up until heroic, it keeps on showing them, and only on legendary it doesn't. That said, if you immediately start playing in Legendary and you have no idea what you're doing, well, good luck. Also, for the record, this is recorded on Normal. I consider doing it on Heroic, not Legendary. That would take far, far too long. I've recently gotten that achievement myself, and that took more time than ever was worth. Still, it's a fun game, and it's mostly for the cinematic value that people still play it, I guess. Because outside of multiplayer, the campaign doesn't really offer that much variance to the other Halo games.
Stand down, Noble. Stand down. Contacts neutralized.
Cheer up, big man. This whole valley just turned into a free fire zone. Cat, we gotta warn Holland. I need you at that relay outpost now.
Ah yes, the dailies. Another thing Reach implemented. It's a nice way of getting extra points for credits, and with these credits you can customize your spawn. It's a nice little thing, but I wish it was an option somewhere to just disable it. It's not that it's annoying or in your way that much. It's just with recordings like these, it pops out of nowhere and you're like, oh, great, this crap. And for all reasons that it's there, it's still kind of annoying. I mean, sure, it'd be nice if it tells you, oh, hey, you're done, but it pops up every 10, 15 kills as well, saying, oh, you're this far along. Ah, yes. The truck with no gun on it. Made just for George, by George, and probably for George in mind, times two. A little trivia, George is the oldest and biggest of entire Noble team, and the man is a walking tank. And here we are demonstrated to how shitty my driving is. This is why I will never have a license, I will never be allowed to drive, and I should be very, very afraid. Also, a nice demonstration of Halo physics. How to get a car stuck. And not get it out. At this point, I probably decided it was a good idea to just run it. That is a thing that somewhat irks me. Now that I think about it, a lot of this game irks me at times. It's, despite the fact that in multiplayer I see balance issues with not using unlimited run. Wait, that came out wrong. What I'm trying to say is, I understand fully that they put a limit on how long you can run in multiplayer. That's logical. However, in single player, there are sometimes long, long stretches, and you can just walk them, you can use vehicles, but let's just say, like, right now, you want to leg it. There's a cooldown. It's nice that they introduced a mechanic, and they teach you how to use it even in single player, so that in multiplayer you can immediately adapt. However, at times I wish they'd just give us an infinite one, seeing as they already took much, much, much more liberties with the single player campaign. Ah yes, another thing. You punch a noble, they don't do much. They're pissed, they might say something, in a rare occasion you might kill them. God forbid when that happens. But 9 out of 10 times, they'll just sit there and be, you know, kind of agitated, and that's it. However, God forbid you nudge up to a Marine and accidentally push the trigger button. The next thing that will happen is he will either A, get very aggravated, start pumping you full of lead, or B, he'll die, and everyone around you, 9 out of 10 times including Spartans, will aim straight for your head and start pelting at you. Something you'd kinda want to avoid. All in all, I also think this is my shittiest commentary in my entire life, and I should burn on the stake for it. However, it's just that the first stage of this game doesn't really give much to talk about. It's giant open fields, which are rendered pretty nice, and the music is really good, actually. But yeah, fuck that one. I was like, okay, you're gone. I don't care. Out of sight, out of heart. But
this first stage of Reach is kind of bland. It's essentially a long stretch. You walk from A to B, kill everything as you go, get some nice music like this, and yeah, that's about it. I'm sure there's some small parts on Heroic and Higher, especially with Friends, where it gets a little bit hairy, but most of the time it's just you versus the world and you run in a straight line and kill everything. That said, that's most modern shooters now anyways. You either have recovering health, no kits at all, no health bar, something Reach brought back, which I am incredibly grateful for. Sure, there's still minor health regen, and there's regenning shields, but that's Halo. That's just Halo for you. That said, yeah, I'm really glad we have health bars again, and I hope they keep this in Halo 4, because, dear God, modern gaming is essentially chest-high walls and regenerating health. We joke about it, some of us like it, a lot of us don't, and it's often considered nitpicking or wanting to go against progress and get the hell in here, I'm honking for a reason, you assholes. But yeah, it'd be so nice if we could just, for once, get a decent game that has this system. It doesn't even have to be perfect, but, you know, we got the new Duke Nukem. We waited like, what, 10, 15 years? I think 10. Fuck me, sorry. I can't remember. We waited so long for that game. It came out, it was total shit. We're now getting modern games, and they're all like that. It's just generic shooter after generic shooter. The other day I was looking down the aisle, and the only thing that remotely interested me was Battlefield 3, which I picked up on launch, and I love it to death, don't get me wrong. But even that has, to a minor degree, regenerating health. Now, Battlefield has always had that, so it's okay. It's a good game. And it works for it, because it has the realistic bullet drop, everything, you die in like a couple of shots, you need to prone or else you're fucked, that kind of stuff. And then you have games like Fear, modern Halo games like Halo 3. I'm not sure if that counts as modern. The multiplayer, I mean. And all in all, it's balanced. It works fairly well. But when you boil it down, it's all chest-high walls, hiding behind things, popping up with regenerating health, that kind of crap. So, again, I'm really grateful that there are still some games, like Reach, that have regenerating health and a health bar, so that the regenerating stops at a certain point, and the health bar actually is your main concern. Because, dear God, I have missed that. I have missed that so much. That said, I have nothing against games that do have it, but I think I've bitched them out this point long enough. I'm going around in a circle with this. Also, another brilliant demonstration of how I cannot hit an elite that is strafing. That sounds really fucking bad. And the last of the little guys. Another thing that's horrible about the first stage is that it's horrible, horrible if you want anything but a assault rifle. In my case, I kind of like the weapon, so I have no real issue using it. But a friend of mine, who is a sniper freak, will use nothing but pistols, DMRs, and assault rifles. He feels terrible in the first few stages of this game. Because all he can use is the assault rifle, one DMR with 30 bullets and Covenant weaponry, and that just doesn't do it for him. But that said, it's the first stage, and we shouldn't bitch, we shouldn't moan, and we should just get in the choppa and fly off. Obligated Arnie joke, leave me alone.
We're at the relay outpost. Door's locked. Mechanism's been flash fused.
Can you beat it?
I'll dial up my torch, cut the way through. Gonna take some time.
Okay. We're en route to your location. I've got visual.
And it is here that Noble Team comes crashing in like a bunch of retards. Yeah, it's a little hot. There's only like 50 Covenant running around like crazy. That said, this is one of the first little encounters in the game. There's about 6 or 7, if memory serves. This is the only one you can interrupt prematurely because Cat can close the door when you enter. However, all the other ones require you to just kill wave after wave until you beat them all. Once that done, you can progress with the story again, or loading point, or whatever. All in all, considering they're not that hard, but they're quite fun to do at times. Especially if you're playing this with friends. Right now I'm playing it single, obviously, but, you know, you can do this with multiple people. That said, yeah, it's an okay game. It has its perks, it has its up, it has its downs. The up being the music, the graphics, the campaign story, if you will. Some people don't like it, other people do. I, for one, quite enjoy it. But there's also, to me, the little downsides, like these forced, really long, lengthy fights, and it's all about nothing, essentially. This boils down into Cat has to close the door, and you're just keeping him off her ass for a while. That's nice, that's dandy, but it doesn't add value to the plot. You're just sitting there shooting everyone like a retard. That said, it's a shooter, so I shouldn't really be bitching about shooting people. And what the hell is that jackal doing? But yeah, it's fun in its own way, so really, if you haven't played it yet, you don't have it yet, and you can find it really cheap. I mean, nowadays, this game, in the Netherlands at least, is on sale just about everywhere. The Collector's Edition, which gives you the Recon and Super Elite thingy, those are like 30 to 40 euros, and the game on its own is like 20, so if you really want it, you can easily get it. And this is what I was talking about. If you run inside, the door slowly closes. If you were to run back outside, it would open again. So look at Cap just prancing about like she did all the work. And yeah, all in all, good game. Recommended. To an extreme. And if you don't want to buy it and you just want to see the campaign, then, well, keep watching, I say. Yeah, this is the final segment of the first stage, and, well, you'll see. You're in for a treat, though. Number 6, search that body.
Where's the rest of your unit?
We got split. I don't think they... It sounded bad on the comms.
All right, Corporal. Stay put. We'll get you a combat surgeon.
Plasma damage.
Found something.
I'll take that, Six. Not your domain.
I got a live one over here.
Come on. Achika.
Minyan inen. Hard to pick.
It's all right.
Kill
him. We're not gonna hurt you.
You're in.
George.
I got her. Keep still, and I'll release you.
Mick. Eat Vanak.
Booga 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 booga.
It's over.
We've been engaged. Bad guy coming out.
Negative 4, stay on the entrance. 2, handle her. 5 and 6, clear the hole.
And this is where you and the big man take out everything. Well, to an extent, everything. And this is also where they introduced the more elite elites. That's going to sound really silly, but Reach seems to have a ranking system for the elites outside of just their classes. if you've played any of the other Halos, you must have noticed at some point that there's elites in multiple shapes and forms, and some of them really big, big heads. Like, for lack of a better term, they have giant hats. Seemingly, the bigger the hat, the more powerful or higher in rank the elite should be. And, well, this is essentially where they introduce the giant I have a tiki mask for a head elites. I cannot remember what they're called. I think commanders or something like that. The commando elite is like our favorite joke. Toy soldiers. Come on, people. Work with me. 90s. Come on. Ah, yes, this segment. the first time we played this game in total, and we entered this room, we're like, what could go wrong? We're invincible. We're Spartans. And then there was this giant elite with a sword yelling at us and killing us in one off a time. Oh, God. Yeah, this game is a lot of laughs, especially with friends. Again, I'm playing it alone for the sake of not having to rely on other people. As we all know, some of my friends pop up, do some co-op shit with me, and then never appear. Dark and fire. But, yeah. That said, it's all fun and games, so who gives a damn?
How long?
Question of my life. If the question is, when will the station be back online? 2 weeks, earliest. This is plasma damage. All major uplink components are fried.
2 minutes is too long.
Which is why I'm splicing into the main overland bundle to get you a direct line to Colonel Holland. You're in my light, Commander.
Find out what she knows. What's your name? Do you live around here? Arnevim George.
Shara.
Shara? Se potros nev. Your accent sounds familiar. Shapron?
Tangari.
Friend of yours?
Father.
Shainalom. I'm sorry.
Why would you be?
Big man forgets what he is sometimes.
She just lost her father. She needs a full psychiatric workup.
She's not the only one.
Lock it down, both of you. Get her on her feet. The body stays here.
Thank you, sir.
Signa. It's patchy, but it's there.
I'll take it.
Let's not touch anything. We wouldn't want to ground this place.
Getting you. What's your situation? Over.
Colonel, this is Noble One. There are no rebels. The Covenant are on Reach. Acknowledge?
Come again, Noble One. Did you say Covenant?
Affirmative. It's the Winter Contingency.
May God help us all.
There is no God. There's only Zul. And Zul's a dick. Well, with that, we finished the first stage, and, well, it loads up the cutscene for the second one, and those are non-skippable, so, well, they're skippable, but not for the recording. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed the set. Please tune in next time when we'll do stage 2, assuming this render goes well. And if not, well, you people won't notice. I will, and I have wasted then a couple hours of my life rendering this and editing and whatnot. Either way, hope you enjoyed it. Leave some feedback. If you happen to know how to get better quality out of a roxio gamecap, please do tell. Thanks for watching. Later.
Be advised, Kilo 33 and Kilo 34, your current LZ is too hot. Roger that. Dot, stand by to receive a response.
Yes, Commander. Coordinates received. Initiate immediate course correction. The Office of Naval Intelligence Sword Base is presently under siege from a Corvette-class Covenant vessel. Due to the sensitive nature of this facility, use of orbital rounds has been, for the moment, prohibited. Regrettably, my efforts to obtain relevant data on enemy forces have been unsuccessful. However, current defensive forces are insufficient. Oni has requested Team Noble's direct intervention to help secure Sword Base.
All right, people. We're stuck with that ship for the time being. Let's focus on the hostile infantry. Give those troopers a hand. Cat 6, you're out here. George, Emil, you're next. Get prepped.
Let's move, Lieutenant.